Dear friends, good evening all. I welcome all of you to the Mind Your Mind with Stephen Raj. This is a program we are organizing every day. Every day different topics from different personalities. Today we are going to have Dr. Anita Prabhakaran as a speaker. She is going to talk about the screen. Speaking, texting, scrolling, sweeping, liking, reading, forwarding, sharing, posting, clicking, all these are today's our life. So we are all in this process every day, every minute, every hour. So mostly we are doing these things. The screen has reduced. Using the screen has increased. What is the effect? Will it affect our eyes? See, this is a question for every day. Dr. Anita is going to answer for all our questions, whether we can do all these things or not, how much time we can take for these activities, and then what to do. If you are not with the phone, if you are not with the messaging, if you are not with the text, social media, many things are there. Okay. Dr. Anita completed MBBS from Medical College, Calicut, did MS in ophthalmology from Government Medical College, Madurai, DNB in 2002, National Board of Examination, New Delhi, FRCS from Royal College of Surgeon, Glasgow. Worked at MOH in Kuwait quite 14 years. Underwent specialty training as pediatric ophthalmologist. She is an ophthalmologist consultant today. She is going to talk about the title called Increased Screen Time, Impact on Your Eyes. This is the talk today's in our session. I'm handing over the session to Dr. Anita. Anita, you can start your talk now. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much. Just wanted to confirm. I hope my screen is visible.
It is clear.
Yeah. Okay. Okay.
The others are seeing. You can switch on your mic. Okay.
Right. Yes, sir. Stephen, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Right.
Okay.
You can proceed.
Yeah. Good evening, everybody. First of all, let me extend a hearty welcome to all the smart people over there on this smart platform. Now, with the advent of the technological advancement within the last few years, I think we can call ourselves a smart generation. Our phones have become smart, our TV has become smart, our car has become smart, and so on and so forth. But do these have a negative impact on our health and well-being as well? Of course, I think most of us will agree with that. But then, is it practically possible to avoid all these altogether? Definitely not. So today we are going to spend some time together and discuss some tips about how to tackle this. We have to become smarter. We have to outsmart these smart gadgets and let them not have a detrimental effect on our health and well-being. So let's see. It's the addiction, the time of addiction, the screen time rules, starting from small baby till the aged people. We have online classes, pandemic classes, as they are called. We are working from home. We have, after that, the entertainment is again through these electronic gadgets, through the video games. And if the family time together is again through these gadgets and watching TV together. And so it's like from dawn to dusk to nighttime, it's the screen time which rules. There are actually rules for the screen time as to how many hours you have to spend on screen. But when the screen time rules over you, how can you ever even talk about those rules, right? Okay, so let's ask ourselves, how many of you have any of these symptoms, like starting from as simple as eyelid twitching, some pain around your eye, some light sensitivity, that is difficulty on looking to the bright lights, some itching sensation, burning sensation of the eyes, some feeling of dryness, some sticky eyes, sometimes blurry vision, sometimes double vision, sometimes you feel that your eyes are squinting, and the most commonest symptom being headache. If you have any of those symptoms as mentioned, please ask yourself these questions. Do you spend 2 hours or more a day on any of the digital device? Are you sitting very close to the digital device? Are you viewing the device at a wrong angle as is shown in this picture? Do you have a bad posture while you're using your digital device? Like you are lying down on bed, or are you slouching on your chair and looking at the device? Do you have eye problems, even very minor problems, like you're not able to see clearly at a far distance, you're not able to read properly, you're not bothering to correct it with glasses or with contact lenses, or you already have a pair of glasses, but then you're not able to see well with those pair of glasses, even viewing at a distance or at reading. So because you are scared to go to a clinic because of this COVID pandemic, you don't want to get exposed. So maybe you're using the same old pair of glasses which you had been prescribed since about 4 or 5 years ago. One very most important question would be this: do you take breaks while you're working? Are you overworked? Those who are working from home, those who have your family are working from home, can very well identify this to this question, because as you can see in the first picture, you can see that you need to work late hours at night to complete your whole lot of work that is being given to you. And if there are people who work with 2 or 3 gadgets at one time, 2 or 3 screens at a time to complete their work schedule. So do you, are you that kind of a person who don't get a break while working? If any of the, if the answer for any of these questions has been a yes, then you have to consider that you might be having what is known as digital eye strain, or otherwise known as computer vision syndrome. This is, as by definition goes, it's a stress on the eyes which are caused by prolonged exposure to any screen or gadgets. That is about more than 2 hours of exposure to any screen or gadgets. It's actually a repetitive strain injury. It's not like you watch for some time, you just look at it and then you get it. No, it's a repetitive injury because it's mainly due to prolonged exposure, as we mentioned. And it not only affects your vision, it affects many other aspects of your health, your memory, your cognition, so many effects, your physical health. We will come to it later. So there are so many effects due to this digital eye strain, which is possible. And hence, we need to address it, we need to know, and then we need to think what should be done regarding it. As we know, first of all, in order to tackle a problem, we need to know the reason, we need to know the causes, we need to know how it happens and why does it happen. Only then we can effectively get it cured or get it rectified, right? So let me explain to you in 7 different causes, which are the basic reasons why one would get a digital eye strain. Okay, cause number 1 is one of the most commonest cause, one of the most ignored cause, or possibly people are not aware of this cause, is reduced blink rate. As we can see in the picture above, everybody tend to stare when we are looking at any kind of electronic gadgets. We don't blink our eyes. Whereas when we are reading the textbooks, when we are reading the physical books, we usually blink. When we are sitting, casually, we are blinking about 16 to 20 times per minute. But you or me, anyone sitting in front of the computer or a mobile or any digital device, any electronic device, we blink only 4 times per minute. So there's a drastic reduction in the number of times we blink per minute. And what is the importance of blinking? There's a tear film, there's a tear secretion which is happening by the tear gland, which is located in the somewhere around the upper eyelid, okay, this part. So it's when we blink each time that the upper lid will uniformly wet the cornea, the black part of the eye. So it's when we blink each time that the cornea is wetted properly, and there's a uniform layer of tear film which will help the smoothness of vision or the clarity of vision, the comfort to the eyes. It gives a lot of regularity to the eyes. So that helps a lot in maintaining eye health. And what happens when we don't blink properly? You get dry eyes, especially when the air conditioner is on or the fan is on directly on your face. It takes away the moisture from the body and the eyes become dry. And whenever you get dry eyes, these are the main symptoms. You feel like rubbing your eyes, and the rubbing makes it even worse. You always have to know that eye rubbing is really, really bad. So I'll also explain that. But then these are the symptoms of dryness. You get rubbing, you feel like itchy eyes, rubbing eyes, you start to rub the eyes and the eyes become red. And then sometimes you even feel that you don't see properly, there is blurry vision. So these are all sometimes the symptoms of dry eyes. You feel a foreign body sensation, you feel irritation, you get burning sensation. These are all the eye feels sticky. And when you get up in the morning, you feel pain, especially in the waking hours of the morning. You get severe pain in your eyes. These are all symptoms of dry eyes. So now the second cause, and this is also yet another very important cause, is because of a fatigue of an intrinsic eye muscle. There are small muscles inside the eye which helps you focus for near and for distance. As you can see in the animated picture below, you can see that there is a muscle which has to contract when you are focusing at a near distance, whereas it totally relaxes when you're looking at a far distance. So this particular muscle, when you're looking at an electronic gadget, it has to be in a state of partial contraction. Okay. But as I said, when you're looking at a far distance, this muscle is totally relaxed, whereas when you're staring, and as I told you, we don't even blink, we keep staring at an electronic device. So in those cases, you find that the muscle is in a state of partial contraction. It's just like holding a glass of water. Just imagine that you're holding a glass of water like this. So maybe for about half an hour or 1 hour, you don't feel anything. But then after 4 or 5 hours, can you move this hand? You can imagine the amount of pain and cramps and aches you will feel on this muscle, right? Similarly, even though this is not a very strenuous job, it's a prolonged contraction or prolonged staring at that particular distance, focusing at that particular distance, which makes this muscle really tired. And then what happens? You get this blurry vision and headache, because this muscle, when it gets fatigued, when it gets exhausted, the symptom is headache. So that's why you hear your children say that after studying for some time, after playing video games for some time, they get a headache. That's because of this constant focusing at a particular distance for a prolonged time. So one more thing what happens is, I want to bring to your attention, is that when we are reading textbooks, the eyeball is facing downwards, that exposure of the surface of the eyeball is much lesser than when we are looking at a computer or another electronic device. So the exposed area of the eye is also more, therefore the chances of dryness is also more in those cases. In fact, there are lots of differences between reading the printed text and the digital text. Like when we are reading the printed text, we have to, it's much easier. It's the eye which moves. The eye has to move along the text. Whereas when we are reading the digital text, what happens is it's the eye is almost fixed and it's the pixels which moves, and the eye has to identify the pixels, which is a lot of strain on the eye. So there are many such differences between reading a text and reading a digital screen. Okay, now coming to the third cause is something related to the screen. Okay, so the most important being the glare. As you can see here, in the picture below, you can see how much the glare from the screen is affecting one's eyes, and you know, it is really really very it's too much of a discomfort for a person to view on a screen with too much of glare. And the brightness, the screen brightness also is very, very important. It should match the room brightness. That is the most important thing. People think that if they keep the screen brightness very dim, they are not it's not harmful, but that is not the state. You have to match the screen brightness to the room brightness. So when you sit in a room, the brightness on the room should be the same as the brightness on the screen, in order that your eye is not getting strained. Okay, and the third one is the font size. Please make sure that you're all keeping the font size larger or bigger enough so that it is not having a bad effect, or it's not causing a strain on your eye. So these are the screen settings which would cause a strain on the eyes. Next cause, or the fourth cause, is improper room lighting. So as I mentioned earlier, the room light and the brightness of the surrounding has to match with the brightness of the screen. And as you can see, it's so obvious that when you watch the screen in the dim light, it is always detrimental, or it's always harmful to the eyes. And one more thing to take care of is the light coming from behind. If the light source is behind your head, it falls on the screen and it causes the glare on the screen, which is really disturbing to the eyes. And similarly, exactly like the light coming from the front is also equally harmful, because when you are sitting in a room with a large window, you have to always make sure that the windows are on the sides. They are not in the front or behind, because as you can see in these pictures, the screen kept in front of the, like when you're facing the window, the light coming from the window is too bright that it is causing too much strain on the eyes. So these are the few things you have to take care about the lighting of the surrounding or the room. Okay, now cause number five is poor posture. As is very much clear from this, as I had shown in the even in the one of the previous pictures, slouching, like sitting with your improper positioning of your back and your neck, if puts too much stress and strain on your back muscles and your neck muscles. And why am I speaking about it? Because many patients come to us complaining of headache, and they think it's because of the blurry vision, or something to do with their vision, or eye pressure or something. But mostly we find that it has nothing to do. Their eyes are perfectly fine, but it is the referred headache from the neck. So people having spondylosis, people having even postural abnormalities putting strain on their neck will surely come with either, they might not be experiencing neck pain as it is, but they can always come with a headache, a referred headache. And look at this picture. As you can see, the child is going so close to the screen. That is also not good. That is also really bad, because you should maintain a distance of at least 2 feet from the screen, so that the eye is also relaxed. But this particular posture, going too near to the computer, will put a strain on your neck as well. And all of you must have heard about text necks, right? So all of us using mobiles nowadays with the bent neck, that's putting a lot of load on the head, and therefore it causes severe neck pain and therefore referred headache. And this is yet another bad posture which many children, not even children, adults as well, take up to. They lie down and they look at their electronic gadgets, and this is very common with mobiles and tablets. Therefore, you have to insist that even tablets have to be kept at an arm's distance so that it doesn't cause any harm to the eye. Okay, now comes the next issue, is the uncorrected refractive errors, or you know, uncorrected vision problems. Whenever anybody sees a blurry vision, as I mentioned before, people are reluctant to go nowadays to the doctors. They don't want to go in in crowded hospitals or in clinics because they don't want to get exposed. Therefore, they try to adjust with their glasses, but they don't realize that they are causing more and more strain to their eyes. And that is yet another reason why you have to get a proper pair of glasses. Now comes some miscellaneous causes. This, I put it under the category 7. As I told you, air conditioners and fans directly facing your eyes are facing your onto your face, blowing onto your face are really harmful because they are a very important cause of dryness. And then next is eye muscle imbalance. As you can see in this picture, there is a child with a squint. And the squint, what it does is it causes difficulty in convergence or, you know, difficulty in reading as, you know, the two eyes cannot come together to focus. So that again will cause, put strain on the eyes. And the third one, I have put it as poor hydration and unhealthy diet, which is very, very important. People don't take care of their water intake, amount of water they drink, and that unhealthy diet, I need not mention about that. With this pandemic time, everybody is with Swiggy and Zomato and getting all sorts of junk food, which is also not very good for your health as it is. And mental stress, working from home. I know people who are undergoing a lot of mental stress. Children who are having their schools online are also having mental stress. So stress is yet another factor you need to tackle and you need to address too. Relax your mind and your body. And of course, lack of sleep. You must all have heard that there is some role of some hormones or some this melanosomes pigments, how they will keep the brain active. If you keep watching the gadget throughout the night or, you know, throughout just before you go to sleep, as your brain cells will be constantly active and it will not let you go to sleep thinking it's daytime. So that is yet another reason for insomnia and therefore severe tiredness. So we have seen there are 7 causes. I have categorized it as 7 causes. Now we should know what we should do to tackle all these. Okay. So first of all, as I said, reduced blink rate is the cause for dryness. Let us voluntarily blink more often. Let us remember to blink more often when we are looking into any gadget. That gadget means anything like phone, computer, tablet, television, any gadget for that matter. Let us remember to blink more often. The second rule, or the golden rule it is called, is, as I told you, there's a muscle which is keeping on focusing at one particular distance, undergoes fatigue and exhaustion. We need to relax that muscle. And how does that happen? By changing the focus. So change focus every 20 minutes. This particular rule is known as 20-20-20 rule. That is, every 20 minutes, take your eyes off the computer, off the digital device, and change focus. Look out through the window, through the door, at something which is 20 feet or beyond for 20 seconds. So it's just take a break of just half a minute during your work time and then look out, change your focus and look out through the window or your door so that you're looking at a far distance. As I told you, when you look at the far distance, the eye muscle is totally relaxed. So this is a very important rule you need to always remember. Every 20 minutes, take a break of 20 seconds and look at something which is 20 feet away. Okay. So there are actually lots of apps nowadays available. You can incorporate it in your computer or your mobile or whatever you're working with. It says every 20 minutes, it just pops up and says, take a break. Your eyes need a break. Take a break. So, you know, sometimes you keep on working. You never know how long you're going on working. So you need to take a break. So the computer or your device itself can remind you to take a break. And when you are taking a break, you can wash your face with cold water. You can do palming. I hope all of you know what is palming. You can just rub your hands like this. Close your eyes gently, just like sleeping. Don't close it tightly, just gently. And then keep your warm palm over your hands, a warm palm over your eyes. That really helps in relaxing the eye muscles a lot. And yet another thing what you can do is cold compresses. You can dip some, you need not have ice packs. I would rather prefer everyone to use cold compresses by using something soft like a cotton ball or a tissue. You can roll a ball of tissue, or you can take some soft cloth. You can dip it into ice cold water and keep cold compresses. It really relaxes the eyes. It takes away the itching sensation. It helps in relieving all the symptoms of dryness. It takes away the sensation of, you don't rub the eye. When you feel like rubbing, if you keep cold compresses, you don't feel like rubbing anymore. So keeping cold compresses really helps in relaxing the eye. Okay. Now, the third reason what we said was the poor room light, right? So we need to modify the workspace ergonomics, because as we know, when we are working in the office, the ergonomics is already taken care of. But when we are working at home, we need to find out what is the best possible way to modify your workspace. So the how to avoid glare is mainly, as I told you, the light should come overhead or it should come from the sides. The light should be either overhead, as you can see in this picture, or it should come from the sides. So as you can see in this picture, the windows should always be on the sides, not in the front, neither behind nor front. It should be on the sides, or any light source, if it is on the side of the room, it should be on the side. You should place your workplace like that, and the light should come from above or from the sides. So these are the most important thing, and never allow any light source to directly fall on your face or onto the screen. And the second one is, as we said, the screen settings. And one thing I want to tell you at this juncture is, please try to use only one screen at a time, because there are many people who use different gadgets. You know, they have a phone here, they have maybe one or two phones in the front, they have a computer, and then they have a tablet, and then the TV will be on. So many gadgets together. So this will really be harmful to your eyes. So make sure that you're using one gadget at a time. So that will relieve the digital strain to a great extent. Second, as I told you, increase the font size, whichever suits you, and it doesn't cause a strain to you. Third is switch on the night mode in the gadgets. And there is something called color temperature. You know, there's a color temperature chart, what you can see on the computers, and you can set it. It is said that you have to go for cooler colors during the daytime and warmer colors for the nighttime. Most of the computers have this in their own, it adjusts, most of the screens, they do the automatic adjustment. But then if your screen doesn't do that, please make sure that that is what the night mode does. So it if your screen is not having this particular setting, it should be this setting can be incorporated into your screen, which helps in relaxing your eyes. Another thing what you can do is a blue light filter, because the ultraviolet rays coming from the screen is the most harmful to the eyes. So you can incorporate a blue light filter onto your screens, which also relaxes the eyes. And as I said before, we have to adjust the brightness of the screen to match with the surrounding brightness. As you can see in this room, it's a well lit room, it's a very bright room. That's the best way you should work. And in that, the screen brightness should be kept in such a way that when you switch on the screen, it should not be different from the screen should not be a source of light. That is how you have to to put it simply. So the screen should not be seen as a source of light. The screen should have the same brightness as the surrounding. And yet another method is, that is what the picture what I have shown below. They say you can keep an A4 size paper and in front of your computer, and see that the paper should not be, the screen should not be brighter, should neither be brighter nor be dimmer than the paper. It should have the same brightness as the paper. That also, that is yet another way you can identify how to keep the brightness of the screen to the best possible way. Okay, now the fifth tip is correct sitting posture. So how do we keep the computer? We have to make sure that the screens are placed at an arm's distance or 2 feet distance. or minimum of 25 to 30 inches away. There are different ways in saying that. So with whatever way you can, it's one easy way to remember is it should be at an arm's distance, at least at an arm's distance. But if you have a bigger screen, it should be even further away. And the top edge of the computer should be at your eye level. So don't keep the computer below or don't keep the computer above. So that eye level, the top edge of the computer should be at the eye level. Then the center of the computer should have an angle of 15 to 20 degrees from the horizontal. As you can see here, see the center of the screen should be slightly below the eye level. So that is when your eyes will just slightly dip down to see the center of the screen. That is the ideal position. And along with that, you have to also make sure that your feet is well placed, it's well supported, your back is supported, your neck is supported, and that your arms and your wrist, and you know, you have to make sure that all these, you can tilt the screen to such a position that it doesn't reflect the light from above. Sometimes if the screen is tilted too much, you see that the light from above is reflecting from the screen. That is also not good. So that is why you have to adjust the screen position so that it is causing minimal discomfort to the eye. I hope I'm clear. And now comes the sixth tip, regular eye checkup. Nothing like that, because we have nothing like you should not think that you should not go. We can wear masks. We can make sure that you're using hand sanitizers properly. You can take appointments. There are many hospitals which give which go by appointment basis these days, so that you don't need to go there and wait along with the public. You can go have your checkup done and then come back. And but I cannot overemphasize the importance of having a regular eye checkup. It's not only for identifying vision problems. There are a lot many things we need to identify by having an eye checkup. But unless we check for it, we will not identify. I don't know if you are all aware, there is an entity, there's a new entity which has come up, which is known as quarantine myopia. It's really strange, because children spending, not only children, even we find that, usually we find that the power of the eye, especially the short sight, it increases up to the age of 20 years. From 20 to 40 years, it's usually stable. It doesn't change much. But these days, we are getting lots of patients in their 25s and 30s who come with an increase in their short sight, increase in their minus power. Why is that? It's because of excessive gadget use and also excessive indoor activity. As I said, the eyes, the muscle inside the eye is not getting an opportunity to relax. It's just people are staying indoors, and when they are looking up from the screen, the maximum distance their eye can look up to is only till the walls of the room. So they don't, the muscle doesn't get a chance to look at far distance. It doesn't get a chance to relax itself. So that contraction of the muscle is one of yet another cause for elongation of the globe. And when the globe size increases, becomes longer, that causes short sight or myopia, or that is known as that is one kind of refractive error, where you get minus powers to be added to your glasses. So unless you go and check, you never identify. Before, when there were schools, you know, children are missing schools these days. Before, we used to say that people of 60s and 70s used to say that, oh, I miss my school days. Now poor children of 14 and 15 are missing their school days nowadays. So when they are sitting in the classroom, when they are asked the rotation, you know, all of us know about the rotation in the classroom. So when we are sitting in the back bench, children easily identify that they're not able to see the blackboard. So they come to us for checkup very soon. But now, since everything is so nearby, these short-sighted children, they don't identify at first that they are not able to see the screen properly. So, I mean, their vision is getting low. So that's yet another reason why we need to have regular checkup. Okay. So, and as I told you, these eyeglasses, I was telling you about the ultraviolet protection for the screen, right? You can have the blue light filtering or blue light blocking in the glasses as well. That can be incorporated. The ultraviolet filtering techniques can be incorporated in your glasses, which is very commonly done these days, so that you can protect your eyes from the ultraviolet spectrum of the harmful radiation. Okay. And I was telling you, only when you meet the doctor, you will identify that whether you have some other issues, like you have some allergies, or you have cataract, you have glaucoma, you have many other issues for that matter, some infections, or so we can treat you when what as and when required. But one thing we can do is, like, sometimes we give even a moisturizer drops, because you can try all these methods of not preventing a dry eyes, blink more, wash your face, and do take breaks and whatever I told you. But then if all these doesn't work, sometimes even the dry eyes are so severe, you may need to have some lubricating or a moisturizer drops, which are just artificial tear drops, which are available over the counter, but then it relaxes your eyes and it helps treat the dryness and relieves your symptoms to a large extent. And other ailments, if any, will also need to be treated. Okay, so, and then we have to think of our importance of our healthy diet. And any for easy remembrance, I would tell everyone, any fruit or vegetable which is yellow or orange in color is good for your eyes. Okay, so it includes carrots, papaya, pineapple, pumpkin, bananas, capsicum. So it's just like any fruit or vegetable which is yellow or orange in color is good for your eyes. There are lots of others as well, fish and egg and everything, sweet potatoes are all very good for your eyes. And proper hydration, I need to emphasize on this, because people who are sitting in the air conditioner room especially, they don't feel the thirst, so they don't drink enough water. Elderly people don't drink enough water, because they, for them also, the thirst sensation is much lesser. So you need to drink more water to prevent dryness. So these are the main 7 points, but I would like to add few more points. One is, as I said, prolonged screen time is the cause for the digital eye strain. So prolonged, the word, so as it goes, we need to restrict screen time. How much? The allowed screen time is only 2 hours a day. Actually, for pediatric, it's different. American Academy of Pediatrics suggests that there should be no screen time for children less than 2 years. Many of you who are listening to me would be knowing that many parents, before we used to feed the children by showing the crow, showing the mountain, showing the trees. But nowadays, many mothers are finding it very easy to keep a mobile and or a computer or a tablet or TV. They resort to it to feed their children, but it is not good. We have to know that up to 2 years of age, they are not allowed, the screen time is not allowed for children. And from 2 years to 5 years, it's about half an hour. And from 5 years till 20 years, it's about 2 hours. And even beyond 20 years, the screen time, recommended screen time, is only 2 hours per day. Because the time away from the screen, as you all know, needless to say, it encourages a healthy physical, social, mental development, right? And sometimes the next sentence I included includes all electronic devices. You know why? Because then sometimes when I tell my patients only 2 hours per day, what they do is they spend 2 hours on computer, then they switch it off, and then they go to 2 hours for mobile games, and then they switch it off, they go to 2 hours of computer. So, you know, the 2 hours encompasses all electronic devices all together. Okay, so because as you know, too much of screen time will result not only in eye issues, lots of physical issues like obesity, sleep issues, neck and back problems, depression, anxiety. Children score less because their memory is less, their attention is, there is deficit, they develop attention deficit syndrome. So many, many issues are coming up because of excessive screen use. And as I said, in order to get a proper sleep, we need to avoid viewing any electronic device at least half an hour before sleep. One more important tip I want to tell everyone is, please don't rub your eyes, because many patients who are coming to us are having issues because they are rubbing the eyes. So I'll just explain what happens when you rub the eyes. But why do you rub the eyes? First of all, you rub the eyes because you may have dry eyes, you may have allergy, you may have some vision problems, or some many other reasons. So these are the main reasons why someone would rub their eyes. But then what happens when you rub the eyes? When you rub the eyes, there are so many things happening. First of all, there is a chemical which is being released inside your eye, which initiates allergy. So allergy starts And then what happens? This causes small, small, small pimples to appear inside your eye. Once these pimples occur, you feel like a foreign body sensation. You feel that there's something fell into your eye. And then you start rubbing even more. The more you rub, the more of the chemical, the more of the small pimples, and the more foreign body sensation. And then you rub more. So it continues as a vicious cycle. So you need to break that by stop rubbing your eyes. So how do you stop rubbing your eyes? When you feel like rubbing, how do you stop it? You just go splash your face with cold water. You can dip some clean cloth or any tissue or cotton ball, as I told you, into cold water. Keep over your eyes. Keep cold compresses. It helps in relaxing your eyes. You don't rub the eyes anymore. And then slowly it gets better. If it doesn't get better by that, you need to consult a doctor. We can give you some lubricants. We can give you the anti-allergic medications and even some other medications if as and when necessary. So with medications, surely you'd be able to stop. But what I want to impress upon you is that the more you keep on rubbing, any of these medicines is not going to have any effect. You will have to stop rubbing the eyes, and then only you will have your eye health will be definitely better. And in children, there is actually another risk factor. When they keep rubbing the eyes, the shape of the cornea changes, and they can even develop cylindrical power. In the common term, like astigmatism can even be presented because of constant rubbing of the eyes, and that can even worsen to a very severe condition known as keratoconus even. So rubbing eyes is really bad. So you need to make sure that nobody in your family is rubbing eyes at all. And many patients, they come to us with red eyes and with symptoms just because they had been rubbed. They get swollen, all the eyelids get swollen, and you know, so many symptoms. But all these are attributed only to rubbing of the eyes. So please make sure that you do not rub the eyes. And this is the final word. Please spend more time outside. Outdoors, the more time you spend outdoors, the eye is more relaxed, and even it's good for your health as well, because as you know, fresh air, and there's nothing like bright sunlight and fresh air, right? Especially in children, they say minimum 2 hours of sun exposure is needed to keep their eye health, to keep that for their proper eye growth. So nowadays children are lacking that. So what I'm telling the children now is, please take your whatever gadget you're doing your online classes with, please go outside, sit in your garden and attend the classes on your terrace, in the sit out, in the balcony, please. So that, you know, you get the sun exposure. And also whenever you're looking up from the screen, your eyes are automatically looking at a far distance, which relaxes the muscle, and therefore it's good for the eye health. So I don't know who posted this. I got it online. So these are, I opened 2 gifts this morning and they were my eyes. And I really, really appreciate that thought. We have to identify what a great gift God has given us. And if you take good care of them, the eyes will also thank you. Thank you very much all for the patient listening. And I think we can open up for discussion.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. My first question.
Yeah.
2 hours screen time. Is it possible for IT employees?
Yeah. That is what, yeah. See, that's what I was saying in the initial stage. It is absolutely not possible, practically not possible for all of us to restrict the screen time. So that is why I was mentioning we how to tackle the excess screen time. What are the tips we can do? So these are the various tips we can incorporate, like modify your workspace, make your screen glare. Glare free, or reduce glare on your screen, reduce the brightness, adjust the brightness so that it matches with the surrounding, increase the font size, and most important, take regular breaks. So even if you work for on an average now, because work time, it's working from home, people have to spend at least 8 hours, minimum 8 hours on the screen, or even more. Yes, I agree. Even more, you know, people have to spend on the screen. But then when you take regular breaks every half an hour, and when you take the break, if you can assort to like a washing face, keeping cold compress, using the lubricant drops, blink your eyes more, and keeping the settings so that it is not harmful to the eyes. So all these will definitely help in relaxing the eyes and not putting a strain on your eyes, and therefore it will help in preventing digital strain. So although the time restriction is not possible, see, the main reason why we put a time restriction is for people to know, please be aware that, you know, there is something called time limit for screen, so that, you know, you don't, after your work is over, your relaxation is by playing a mobile game. That is not allowed. So at least you don't play a game with a mobile. You go out and play, or spend some time outdoors. So that was my purpose of mentioning.
Good. So nice, actually. See, you covered the entire thing, not only from not only eyes, actually. You covered the stress and the body, everything, actually. It is very informative. It is open for the questions and views of the public. Please, anyone can talk.
I start.
Even people can talk in Tamil, and then they...
I can
answer in Tamil, because konjam pesuven in Tamil.
Actually, I have two questions, ma'am.
Yes.
I am wearing the glass,
okay,
for reading purpose only. Most okay. of the time, the same glass I used to wear.
Mm-hmm.
Is that it will affect anything?
Okay. So first of all, let me ask you, how old are you?
Near about 53.
Okay. So how long have you been using these pair of glasses?
Last 3-4 years.
3-4 years. Okay. So usually after the age of 40, we get what is known as presbyopia.
Okay.
I don't know what you call presbyopia in Tamil. In Malayalam, we call it vellazhuthu. I don't know in Tamil.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So, you need a plus power for reading. Okay. And that particular power keeps changing every 2-3 years. So if you have been wearing a glass for 3 years at a stretch now without changing the lenses, and if you are able to read at a normal reading distance, so normal reading distance is about 30 to 40 centimeters. If you're able to read at that distance, well and fine, no issues. But if you need to stretch your arm with your present glasses, that means you need a change of glasses.
Okay. Every year I used to change the glasses, ma'am,
okay,
with the eye testing. What is my problem? Used to wear the progressive glass.
Okay, very good.
Adjust my side. I have neck pain. That's why I changed to the normal glass.
Oh, okay.
After that, what's happening? I forgot to remove the glass for always. I used to wear always.
Okay, if you are using a progressive glass, that means the upper part of your glass is for viewing the distance. The middle portion is for intermediate distance, that is your computer distance, about 60 to 90 centimeters. And then you have the lower portion of your glass for reading distance, 30 to 40 centimeters. So if you have a progressive glass, you can very well wear it all the time. You don't need to remove them. Because already...
If I wear the progress glass,
mm-hmm,
when I'm using the computer, I have to adjust my eyesight.
You have to adjust
your head. Because of the corona, I'm getting the neck pain.
You have to adjust your neck.
I have some cervical disorder. I'm not able to adjust my like that.
Yeah. So what the solution is, you have to adjust your table and your position of the computer. Okay, you have to adjust the position of your chair, you have to adjust the position of your table and the place where you are keeping the computers, so that your neck is comfortable, and with that particular distance, as I told you, like the angle should be about 15 to 20 degrees. The center of the screen should be 15 to 20 degrees below your straight viewing line. So that puts much, that is the place where the intermediate distance is in your glasses as well. The upper part is for viewing distance, the lower part is for viewing near, the middle part is for viewing the intermediate distance, that is the computer. So if you have to adjust the chair and the table and how you have kept your computer, that is what you need to do to relieve strain on your neck.
Okay, thank you. But I'm adjusting my chair and monitor only. Monitor, there is a possible up and down.
Yeah.
LCD monitor nowadays.
Exactly.
Second question, madam.
Yeah.
I don't want to wear the glass. I can go for operation, for laser operation.
Okay. You're 53 now, right?
Yeah.
So at the age after 40, it will not be like, even if you go for, there are procedures to take away glasses for near and for distance as well. But then once you have crossed even 50, practically speaking, in about 10 years, you will get cataract. You will start getting cataract. Okay, cataract is something exactly like graying of hair. The color of the lens inside the eye changes from transparency to white in color. Just like the hair changes from black to white, the lens changes from transparent to white. So definitely you will develop a cataract. So instead of undergoing a LASIK or a procedure on the cornea, it would be better that you undergo a procedure to exchange your lenses. That is, just like a cataract surgery, you can have your lens replaced with a lens which will be multifocal, or you know, there are many kinds, different types of trifocal lenses, multifocal lenses, which helps you that you need not wear glasses for near. You can view the distance and for near equally clearly. So that would be my suggestion to you.
What is, madam, what is the terminology you used for cataract surgery?
Not exactly cataract, because you may not be having cataract now, but yes, yes. Either you can wait for some more time until you develop cataract and then undergo the surgery, or this is another method known as refractive lens exchange, where we remove the natural lens and we place an artificial lens with the multifocal special lenses.
But that lens, what is the validity, ma'am? Maybe
validity is lifelong. We even put lenses for even congenital cataract, like children, newborn children have cataract. We put them the lenses. It stays with them lifelong. It's, yeah.
Thank you. Thank you very much. It is
most more welcome.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Vasanti, madam.
Okay, Anita, thank you so much. My name is Vasanti Raman.
Very nice meeting you, ma'am.
I'm calling from Houston, Texas.
Okay. Okay. Yeah.
I enjoyed your talk, and you covered a lot. You gave us so many tips, and you also stressed how important it is to avoid computer screens and all those stuff. Mm-hmm. I have been working as a medical radiographer.
Okay, that's a professor
of medical radiography for quite
a long time. So it's PACS, and then you are always on the computer, I can imagine.
On the computer, online. Being on, and also I had to screen. We had to screen this screen all the time.
The reason
I really retired a little earlier is because during the pandemic, we almost like I thought I'm on the screen for 12 hours or so.
Exactly, and
we had to give tests with the screen, and I had to correct all the assignments on the screen, and it was very difficult. You mentioned a lot of the 20-20-20 rules.
Exactly.
Really useful. But my question is, like, as a pediatric doctor, are you suggesting this to the teachers? Because nowadays, what happens, like, you know, they are forced to see the students have no other choice, but they have to be on the screen all the time. Many teachers may not know this rule. And also, like, e-books are the only way to go now. The book, like, in future, the printing is going to be obsolete. It's going to be e-books, already it has come. Everyone is using only e-books. So is it possible, as a doctor, like, you know, any way we can tell this to the teachers about the 20-20 rules? So 20 minutes of screen time in the classroom, and 20 minutes to do something else, or just take a break. Come back 20 minutes. Maybe like educators should take it over from the doctors to the educators. I think it'll happen. But another thing I want to tell you is, like, the blue filter you were talking about. In here, like, you know, in the colleges, in the computer centers here, they have a screen. The computer screen will be covered by the blue filter screen.
Yeah.
So all the students who sit in the computer center will not be looking at the glaring bright light. They brought that into the computer centers. Maybe they can do that in India. But it is very costly for anybody to have a blue screen. I do not know the cost to put it on the screen. Maybe, like, you know, it is cheaper. But on the whole, like, you know, your talk was very eye-opener. I got something out of it today that, you know, I have to step out more. And then, you know, I keep, because it's hot here, it's now summer, so I give all these excuses not to go out, you know, oh, okay, it's hot. So, but the far and near vision how your eyes corrected. You gave a very good insight into that, and I really appreciate all your effort. Thank you for sharing your ideas and tips with us. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So before, I just need to clarify 2-3 points. One of the point is that you said you are a radiographer. I was just imagining you sitting inside those closed rooms, because all those CT, MRI rooms and the side rooms are so, they're just
dark,
so
very
tiny
dark
rooms and dark rooms. And, you know, you have all lots of those monitors.
That's right. Over there.
So it's not possible quite not to have a digital strain, but unless you take a break, you know, you make it a point to take a break and then just walk out of the room and just go out and just get some fresh air and come back. So that's about
another thing I want to ask you also, as a medical radiologic technologist, mm-hmm. I had worked a lot with fluoroscopy, where I have to stand very close to the patient.
Yeah.
When the doctor is doing a procedure, I'll be helping, but mm-hmm. I'll be extremely close to the radiation. I mm-hmm. used to be so scared of that. Mm-hmm. We never had the radiation protective eye goggles. The doctor will have, but not us. So we had the thyroid shield. We had all the other things, but not the radio. Lead shield for the eye.
Yeah.
Is it very harmful?
Exactly. It's not that it's harmful, but then radiation does have its effect on the eyes. Like, there are entities mentioned like radiation cataracts and so many. Radiation, very simply, it causes dryness, and then lots of other harmful effects of radiation as can happen in any other part of the body. But in the eyes, the most commonly seen one is dryness and radiation cataracts.
Okay.
Shall I just go back to your suggestions about the school?
Yes.
One thing I want to mention is, me being a pediatric ophthalmologist, I do conduct talks for schools, and I make, you know, teachers are also participating, and I make them aware that, you know, you need to take breaks. But then it doesn't happen like 20 minutes and then 20 minute break. No, it's after 20 minutes, it's a 20 second break, which is very easy.
Oh, okay. Okay. 20 okay. second break. Yeah. Okay.
So it's after every half an hour. Basically, it's like take a half a minute break after half an hour of work and then look out through the window to the infinity. Oh. Okay, just a far distance. So that's how it happens. And then,
you got
it wrong. It was like, I should have made it more clear. So after 20 minutes of screen time, it's 20 seconds of change of focus. And look out through the window at something which is 20 feet away. That's how it is. And the second thing is, what I want to mention, that is what I'm trying to advise all my patients, all the children who are coming to my clinic. I'm telling them, please take your gadget or your whatever you're using for your classes and sit outside. So, you know, when they sit on the terrace, on the balcony, or on the garden, and when they sit in the garden and they do their classes, the advantage is, whenever they're looking up, you know, whenever they are taking their eyes off the computer, they're automatically looking at a far distance, and therefore the eye strain can be decreased to a very large extent. So that is something which is very much useful, especially for small children. Yeah. So
thank you so much, doctor. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Lata, ma'am.
Good evening, doctor.
Good evening.
One thing I want to tell you, if you don't keep your mic closer, then volume is coming down.
Oh, really? Sorry. Nice. Thank you for telling me that. Yeah. So
I can suggest you one thing. Could you please remove and talk?
Remove?
Remove your mic and talk. Am
I audible now?
Yeah, you just
very nice. Ah, okay. Okay, then I thought, you know, mic would give a more clarity. That's why I was trying to, okay.
Straight gives more volume. Super.
Okay.
One thing is, each and every sentence of your talk was very, very useful for us.
Thank you very much.
And most important one is, everything is important. Most thing is that we have to blink a lot, you said. From that moment, I started blinking. And next thing is, one big question I want to ask you. Before this, Vasanthi ma'am, sir asked, you know, some question. It's extension I'm asking you. See, cataract operation done. That time, nowadays, that intraocular lens, keeping that intraocular lens is mandatory, no?
Yes, so, exactly.
Mono and bifocal, two things are there.
Yeah.
And bifocal, if you keep, some patients told, some glareness is coming. I'm unable to see, they are telling. So which one you, do you prefer, ma'am?
Okay, see, basically to make a choice between monofocal lenses and multifocal or trifocal lenses, not bifocal. Bifocal usually we mention for glasses, okay, and for intraocular lenses we say trifocal or multifocal lenses. Okay, so to differentiate, the basic thing is whether you need to, whether you have to wear glasses for reading after your surgery, or whether you can be free of glasses. So that is the difference. So the choice has to be purely personal, that it varies from person to person, because the reason why I'm saying this is because it depends on your professional requirement. It depends on how, what kind of work do you do. If you are a housewife and you don't mind, you know, you don't have much work to do near work, like in between, maybe you will read for some time, or maybe you will stitch in between, or, you know, you don't do much of a near work. Your work is more in the distance, like you will watch TV for some time and then you will do some household chores. So in those people, we would rather prefer to go for a monofocal lenses and to, and let them use glasses for near vision. You know why? Because as you said, it is not easy to get adjusted to the multifocal or trifocal intraocular lenses. As sir, another sir who called me, he was mentioning, you need to adjust, you need to get to know, you need to find out the actual distance at which you are able to see clearly, and then gradually you will get used to it. Actually, it's not a big deal, but then some people, they are very apprehensive towards this, they are not very comfortable. So they might not prefer, you know, doing that. They would rather say, I'll have a clear vision for distance and then I'll use my glasses for near. So it's purely personal choice. And but whereas if you are a kind of person who is very much aware cosmetically, like, I don't want to use my glasses, I want to be glass free, I want to, it doesn't matter even if I don't see distance that very clearly, doesn't matter if I get some glare, if I get some difficulty in night driving, I'm not a person who would drive at night, I'm more concerned about my appearance, then multifocal or trifocal is the choice for you. Okay, and then there are some professional requirements as well, because some people, they might need to use distance vision and the near vision and the intermediate distance. So, you know, in a constant basis, like people who are presenting, they have a projector and, you know, they have to look at what they are speaking, they have to look at the public, and then, you know, those kind of change in focus very frequently, those people also benefit a lot from the multifocal lenses. So the choice of the lenses is purely depending on your profession and your personal needs and requirements, I would say.
Okay, out of your experience, that is percentage-wise, patients are preferring which one, doctor?
Mostly, I feel, especially in India, but I can't really say, because now people have started using multifocal a lot these days. So many, many people are opting for it and they're very, very happy about it as well. So.
Okay. Yeah. Why do I ask this question, you know, I think in the 2017, I got a cataract operation.
Okay.
At that time, I got a fear and then I kept on asking many doctors, second opinion, third opinion and all. And of course, those doctors will not know this is second opinion, third opinion. They have told, from my opinion, you can put focal glass lens, they told. So accordingly, I went. But the person who has done surgery, he has suggested for multifocal, but I did not accept his words.
Okay. One more thing is, things are keeping on changing, actually. From 2017 itself, even now, there are newer versions of multifocal IOL coming up, that they are getting rid of these glare, they're getting rid of these night halos, these chromatic aberrations. So many things are being rectified in the newer IOL models. So that is also yet another reason why we are now suggesting that.
Okay, now is it possible to upgrade my
It is not impossible, but it is not suggested.
Okay.
Not advisable. Yeah, because it's an elaborate procedure. It's a very elaborate procedure. It can have lots of complications. You would be very happy like this rather than undergoing the other kind of procedures. Okay.
Yes, sir. Even for seeing message or anything, I have to wear glasses, sir.
One thing what you can do is, as I told you, you can increase the font size in your phone and mobile and phone. That can sometimes, you know, you can read a little bit without the glasses. A little bit, not all fine prints, but if you increase the font size, at least, you know, you can manage a little bit. But then
some people are saying, if you don't use glasses for 15 days or 20 days, then your eyes will adjust and you are able to read. Is it correct, ma'am?
Yeah, I will answer this question. As I told you, at the age of 40, we said 40, vellaluthu starts, right? Yeah. And what is vellaluthu? It's a muscle inside the eye, which helps you to focus at the near. This particular muscle becomes weak, or it just fails to work as strongly as it was working when you were a child. Okay. So this muscle cannot get back its power if you just don't use glasses. That doesn't work that way. If that is the case, then nobody would wear glasses, right? All of us would just not wear glasses for 15 days and then get back the vision. That doesn't happen. The muscle becomes weak. I don't know why God made like that. It's exactly 40 years. That muscle slowly starts weakening, and then it doesn't contract enough to help you focus at that particular distance. So it's basically something to do with the muscle, something to do with the flexibility of the lens and so many things. So I don't think that particular thing is possible, at least scientifically not possible.
Okay. Additionally, lens people are keeping
Contact lenses, you mean? Contact lenses. Yeah.
Is it possible for me?
Contact lenses presbyopic contact lenses are available, because see, in your case, you don't need glasses for distance, right? You need glasses only for reading. So every time when you're reading, you cannot be putting your lenses on and you can't be taking it out whenever you're viewing at a distance. That can't happen. But there are newer contact lenses are coming up, which is like multifocal lenses. We said there are lenses which are coming up, which you can wear all the time, and it helps you look at a distance and the near as well. So it's recent advances. It's like coming up.
That kind of lenses are going to come.
It has come. It has come already.
Has come. Okay.
Yeah.
So I can consult any ophthalmologist and then find.
Yes.
Thank you.
Ravi sir. Good evening, doctor. Very good presentation. Very neatly presented. We are able to understand.
Your voice lower.
We are able to understand.
I can hear, sir.
Okay. I have 2-3 questions. How many years once we will have to do the eye checkup? Number one, any eye exercise you are suggesting? Number three, people are advising that if you glare the sun in the early morning, it is good for health. Is it correct? Apart from that, what is ARMD and what is Hardrucen? Drusen is fine.
Hardrucen. Okay.
Hardrucen.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So first question was,
how many years once eye checkup?
Are you a diabetic or do you have any other comorbidities, any other illnesses?
No.
If you don't have any comorbidities, your eye checkup should be to the age of 40 years, mainly if you have any eye issues. After the age of 40 years, at least once in 2 years, and then after the age of 60, once in a year. Okay. And if you are a diabetic, it again depends on the number of years of diabetic you are. So up to 5 years of diabetes, it can be once in a year. And then after that, it should be once in 6 months. That is how. And then once you start developing any diabetic retinopathy, it should be once in 3 or 4 months, depending on the status we would advise you. So that's about eye checkup. Second question was about
eye exercise.
According to modern medicine, there are not any specific eye exercises to improve vision as it is, except that there are some convergence exercises for convergence insufficiency and things like that. But I've heard of many parallel medical fields, they advise some kind of eye exercises to reduce the eye vision problem. But then what I have seen is many of them, while they do the exercise, it reduces a little bit. But then after they stop it, it comes back. That's from my experience, my limited experience. So I'm not a person to talk about it. From whatever I have seen, this is what I've seen, like children or people who do exercise, at the time when they are doing the exercise, it temporarily, it reduces a little bit, but then that is not a permanent effect. So that's what I have noted. And the third question was about sun exposure. So sun exposure for eye health. Yeah. Sun staring, no. That's actually, right. Sun staring is not at all advised in modern medicine, because according to us, or I think that is a scientific fact also, that when you look directly at sun, so that is what is happening during solar eclipse as well. So when you're directly looking at the sun, there are some harmful radiations which can cause physical damage. Like there is something called solar retinopathy that will damage the most central part of the retina, which is known as macula or fovea, and that causes there are some even changes which are identifiable, which are visible. Changes will happen in the central vision because it affects the macula, which helps us in viewing the central part of the visual field. So it actually has a detrimental effect. I would not advise sun staring at all. But sun exposure, yes. Sun exposure definitely helps. Like, exposure to the body, not directly viewing the sun, is not advisable. And the fourth question was age-related macular degeneration. ARMD is age-related macular degeneration. As I mentioned now, macula is the central portion of the retina, or the nerve of the eye, the back portion of the eye. There is a nerve layer called the retina. The center, the part which helps us to view the center, that portion is known as macula. And this is one of the degenerative changes, as the name itself has it. It's a degeneration. Degeneration means it's an aging change which happens in the center part of the retina. And the sad part of it is that it doesn't have some types of ARMD, they don't have any treatment. And what you were mentioning about hard drusen, there are hard and soft drusen. The drusens are a feature. They are actually a clinical feature. That is how we identify that someone has an ARMD or not. That is like, somebody has a redness when somebody has conjunctivitis. So similarly, drusen is one of the clinical feature of macular degeneration. That is one way of identifying for us, the doctors, when we look into the eyes of a person with the age-related macular degeneration, we see what is known as drusen. So that is the hard drusen. And ARMD, basically, there are two types. One type is the dry type, where you treatment for that. Some people, they worsen and they lose their vision. It's very, very difficult stage. And the second type is wet ARMD, where there is collection of fluid. For that, we have some treatments like injections inside the eye, and some lasers, and some other modalities of treatment are available.
Well, this dry ARMD, what is the symptoms? You have to go for a retina checkup, or how it is? Yeah. After 60 years, I am talking about.
If it has not affected your macula that much, definitely it is identified only by regular checkup. Once it affects your macula, then you will start feeling some blurry vision in the central part of your vision, the central portion. When you're looking at something, the center portion will be blurred. That will be the symptom.
No, recently, I am 64 years old. Recently, mm-hmm. 1 month back, I undergone a muscle checkup.
Okay.
Then they mentioned suspected ARMD and mm-hmm. hard drusen they mentioned.
Okay. They must have given you some vitamin tablets, right? Vitamin antioxidant tablets?
No, nothing like that they have given.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Consult a routine specialist, they are telling. Is it necessary
retina,
to go for?
Not routine. Yeah, routine. It's a retina consultant. Yeah.
Retina.
Yeah. So what the retina consultant does is we make a scan. It's called an OCT scan, optical coherence tomography. It's a scan of the retina, and we get to know whether there is any fluid collection, whether it is of, whether there is a, how much is the thickness, and is there any scarring. So many features we can find out. According to that, we can advise the treatment. That is what is usually done.
Okay, doctor. Thanks.
Sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Ravi sir. Come, please, Rajeshwari.
Good evening, doctor. Good evening. Last 3 days back, I was getting water in my eyes. Is it any problem in my eyes?
Okay. Do you want me to speak in Tamil, ma'am? Which is more comfortable to you? I don't.
Are you from Tamil Nadu or from Kerala?
Both language I come.
Okay, fine. So okay. I'll continue in English. So, ma'am, let me ask you a few questions. How old are you?
I'm
23. Right? Yeah. And yeah. Are you a computer or IT professional, or are you helping? I mean, are you working a lot? Are you spending?
I work as software engineer.
Okay, so most probably one of the reason, I mean, like without examining, it is difficult to pinpoint the accurate diagnosis. But what I would rather say is one of the reason why you might be having a watery eyes is, as I was explaining in my talk, it's each time when we blink that the tear gland, which is secreted in the upper, somewhere in the upper part of the eye, it secretes the tear fluid, right? And it wets the cornea properly each time you blink the eye. So you or me, anyone sitting in front of any electronic gadget, our blink rate is reduced. So when we don't blink, what happens? The cornea is exposed. Cornea means the karuviri or the Krishnamani, whatever we say. It is exposed to the fan, the air flow, the air conditioner. It becomes dry. So when it becomes dry, there are spots which appear on the cornea. These dry spots will send message to the brain that the cornea is dry. The cornea is dry. I want more tear fluid. So what the brain does is it will ask the lacrimal gland to secrete more tears. So whatever tears are being secreted will just flow out through this without doing its purpose, without maintaining the proper tear film, without maintaining a smooth surface on the cornea. What tears are produced more, but then it is just flowing out without doing its purpose. Okay, so that is why some people have increased tearing because of dry eyes. Some people have increased tearing because of eye strain as it is, like what we mentioned today. Some allergy, some kind of infections, all these can have, you know, teary eyes. But then yet another reason is some block in your tear duct. There is a duct through which the tear fluid will drain into your nose. It's on this part. It's on the lower, it's on this side of the nose. So the tear fluid has to come. It has to wet the eye, and then it has to go through the tear duct. It will go through behind your nose, and you will just swallow the tears. So that is how the normal pathway goes on. So if there is any block in that tear duct, again, you will get watering. So these are the few reasons why you would get watering. So what you can do is you can try all these measures, what I told you. You can, you know, take breaks, you can blink more, you can wash your face with cold water often, you can keep cold compresses, and then maybe you can get some lubricant, artificial tear drops like Refresh Tears or something. You can, it's just available over the counter, these lubricant moisturizer drops you can apply and see. If not better, I think you should definitely have a consultation.
Okay, doctor. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Dr. Perumal, sir, please ring now. You want to try something?
Thank you, Stephen.
Please, sir.
One doubt. That is, I am using Amazon Kindle. Yes, it is a normal thing or it's equal to an electronic device?
It is definitely an electronic device, sir, because it's again the pixels, right? Because as I was telling you, reading the text and reading the e-books are totally a Kindle. Are you listening to it? Are you listening to it, or are you reading it, sir?
Reading. It's a self-illuminated device.
I know. But then if you're listening to it, it's fine because you're not putting strain on your eyes. But if you're reading, it is definitely considered to be a electronic device. Right. Nothing, I mean, like, it's not nothing you have to, you don't need to worry, I think, but basically, I think you will need to, you know, take breaks and then, you know, at least consider it as an electronic device and take all precautions, I would suggest.
As usual.
Please prevent dryness. Yeah. Right. Yeah.
Thank you, Lata.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Doctor. Dr. Unnikrishnan, do you want to say something? Are you there? Okay, right. Anybody? So, who else want to talk?
Sorry, if I with you, sir.
Please.
Yeah, first of all, thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
On behalf of me and our group members, thank you so much. We have met more eye-opener speakers. Today only we met the real eye-opener in this session. Thank you so much. So, madam, I have some 3 questions over there.
Yes.
I think some people are asking the glaucoma.
Mm-hmm.
See, how I predict the glaucoma I have or myopia? I am class 50 and then I have diabetes more than 5 years.
Okay.
I'm taking intake of medicine also for diabetics.
Okay.
So when I was go to checking the eye, they're always taking glaucoma test. They say, yes. Like that.
Yes.
Then how can I stable with this? I'm taking intake of medicine and I'm losing my vision. I don't know how long it will be happen.
Okay. No, I didn't actually get your question very clear. Do you have
glaucoma
irukka illaya?
Sorry?
Ungalku already glaucoma irukka illa?
Doctor said they have glaucoma with me.
Oh, you have glaucoma. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So, see, basically I'll tell you something. Glaucoma, even if like anybody, they don't have glaucoma also, we do screening during every visit because glaucoma is a silent disease. It doesn't have any symptoms. Okay. Mostly it won't have any symptoms. It will just, the people will start, continue losing vision from the sides, but they will not realize because the central vision is okay. Nobody will realize. Finally, when the central vision is also gone only, they will realize. So that is why we keep screening. Because once the damage to the optic nerve is done, there is no treatment. So we want to prevent the damage. That is why we are always screening and treating appropriately. Okay. So glaucoma is one disease which you don't need to worry. Once it's identified, you are taking appropriate medications, then you don't need to worry. The only thing is, like, you need to keep the pressures in that normal range. And you, for that, we will not know the pressures, right? If you sit at home or without checking, we will never know the eye pressures. So you have to check the eye pressures on a regular basis. Like once in 3 months, once in 6 months, you need to go to a doctor, check the eye pressure. In the COVID times, I know it is difficult going to a doctor and checking is all. At some point of time in the initial stages of COVID, we were not even doing an intraocular pressure checkup for many people unless it was, you know, come very, very necessary because this comes very close to the eye. But then there are many other kinds of measuring pressures, like which throws a puff of air and all without non-contact methods. So, which is very safe. So you can go and check your eye pressure regularly. So monitoring the eye pressure regularly is one of the very important thing. Also, you need to do some tests, like how much is your peripheral vision being affected? How much is your visual field being affected? So if you keep regular follow-up, I think you can have you don't need to be worried about whether you're losing vision or not. And of course, regarding diabetes, yes, you have to have a strict control of diabetes. Only then you can have a good vision. That is directly related to the control of the diabetes and related to the duration of the diabetes. So you need to exercise regularly. You need to keep your sugar and your blood pressure. If you are a smoker, you have to stop smoking. You have to have a regular checkup of your all the parameters. Like, it's not only the level of blood sugar. You need to make sure that you don't develop any kidney disease, you don't develop any peripheral neuropathy, so many things associated with diabetes, right? Only then you can make sure that you know you maintain a good vision, because strict control of diabetes, and there also it is important to have regular checkup, because diabetic retinopathy nobody can identify without having a look inside the eye. So until and unless we look into your retina, we will not be able to say whether you're developing a retinopathy or not. So that there also you need to have a regular checkup.
So I can take every month or every two times in the month. No. OCT also is possible?
No.
It's OCT, okay for me?
OCT doesn't have any side effect, because OCT does not give any radiation or anything. It is just like a scan, which is it just scans your retinal layers. That's it. It doesn't have any radiation or anything. It is not of any harmful effect to the eye. But you need not do OCT every month or every other month. It depends on if you have any central lesions, like I said, some fluid collection that happens in diabetes as well. So if that is there, then in those situations, you may need to repeat the OCT just to see if the thickness of the macula has come down, if the fluid collection has become more or it has become normal, depending on the treatment you're taking and all. So did you have any fluid in the collection in the macula? Did you have any injection treatment?
No, nothing.
Then you don't need to do OCT every month and all. As I told you, depending on the retinopathy, there is a protocol as to when you have to go for follow-up. So the doctor will advise you. You just need to go according to the advice. That's all.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Rifai. Mogana, ma'am, please.
Yeah, good evening, ma'am.
Very good evening, ma'am.
Thank you so much. It was very nice. I just have a few questions to ask. Yes. I'm an absolute extrovert. I don't have a laptop or I don't use a computer at all.
That's great.
Yeah, I only use the phone. That too, nowadays I'm using it a little for entertainment purposes, which I decided I will not hereafter. but for that, it is only for calling purposes and so on. Now, I would like to ask a suggestion. Can I use certain natural ingredients to enhance the power of eyes? I'm not using a spectacle until now. I am running 55 and I haven't used a spectacle so far, and I'm not diabetic too. Can you give me any natural medicines?
I don't know, like, you know, we have seen, like, as you know, he introduced me in the beginning, I was working in the Middle East for some time. Okay. We used to see some people who are in their 70s who were not using their glasses, no presbyopia, like no vellaluthu, even in that age. They don't develop cataract. They, you know, none of the aging changes are touching them. So we used to wonder what is the reason. Those people, they drink a lot of black tea. They eat a lot of dates, and they eat a lot of some kind of green leafy vegetables. So we really don't know. We used to say that we should do some study on them, whether, you know, to find out what exactly is the cause. But what I would say is it is the oxidative damage, right? Whatever damage or whatever changes are happening due to aging is predominantly oxidative damage, they say. So naturally, antioxidants, whatever natural herbal or whatever ingredient having antioxidants will definitely help prevent aging changes. So that's all I can suggest.
What about glow eyes, ma'am? There's a capsule called glow eyes
it's
available on the counter.
Most of the antioxidant vitamin combinations are available over the counter, and they are glow eye especially is, I think it's a herbal combination. They claim that it is they have more of these because as I was mentioning, in age-related macular degeneration there is a particular combination of vitamins and antioxidants and trace elements like zinc, magnesium, manganese, copper, some amount of vitamin C, a particular concentration of vitamin A, not vitamin A, actually beta carotene and all. So these particular combination will help prevent age-related macular degeneration, was a study, or at least help prevent the progression of age-related degeneration. So that is so I don't think there's any harm in taking it, but then probably I would rather suggest you to take it alternate days, because you don't need to bombard yourself with lot of vitamins and antioxidants. You can have it on alternate days so that you get a dose as well. What I was mentioning was there was a study which was done in school children, small children, that whether taking lots of vitamin A, like carrots, natural source of vitamin A, and there was a study saying that there is some benefit, that the short sight progression, the myopia progression was slowed down for children who were eating one or two carrots, raw carrots every day. But then we don't know how to explain that medically, but then there was a study like that. So just because last I mentioned.
By the way, carrots also you cannot take raw too much, ma'am. Like, you know, what to say, we aren't bunny rabbits. We have to do some poriel and eat that only gets into our stomach, you know, or else you get into indigestion or something. Thank you so much, ma'am. By the way, like, you know, I feel the entire society's perception should be changed. I think the perception of the society has got to change. We have to go to records, the old ways of keeping records, using paper more. Like, you know, one side keeps telling don't use paper, cut down paper and all that, but only using a computer and not using paper for anything. Actually, I have a habit of taking down a grocery list or noting down what are the things to be completed today, but my kids, you know, they keep teasing me for that. I said, why are you using a mobile for everything? They use the mobile for just everything. That has to be cut down. You can't change your perception. So only that is going to change the society. That is only going to save the children, like, you know, use of papers and other notepads, pens, use pens and notepads, that and all should come. Still, we old people have that habit. This younger generation is so pathetic, and I don't know how they're going to take it. Okay, thank you so much, ma'am. It was a very nice meet. Thank you, meeting. Awesome. It was nice to meet you all.
Thank you, Bhuvana, ma'am. Please come.
Vanakkam, madam. Romba thanks ungaloda presentation. A good insight about eyes. சரி எனக்கு ஒரே ஒரு கேள்விதான். என்னோட ப்ராப்ளம் வந்து எனக்கு ஞாபகம் இல்லை எப்ப இருந்து கண் பார்வை வந்து டீட்டீரியரேட் பண்ண ஆரம்பிச்சதுன்னு தெரியாது. 18 வயசுல அஸ்டெரிக் மேனரிசமுக்கு கிளாசஸ் போட ஆரம்பிச்சேன். அப்புறம் ஸ்லோலி இவென்ச்சுவலி இப்ப ஷார்ட் சைட்டட்னஸ், லாங் சைட்டட்னஸ், அஸ்டெரிக் மேனரிசம் எல்லாம் கலந்து இருக்கிறதுனால ஐ கான் வேர் கான்டாக்ட் லென்சஸ், ஐ கான் டூ லாஸ்டிக், ஐ கான் டூ ஆல் திஸ். அவர் சொல்லிட்டாரு நீங்க விதம் விதமா ஃப்ரேம் மட்டும் மாத்தி கண்ணாடி போட்டுக்கோ அப்படின்ட்டு. சரி, அதெல்லாம் இப்ப பிரச்சனை இல்லை. அது லேர்ன் டு அக்செப்ட் தட் ரெடி. இப்ப மேக்னிஃபைங் கிளாஸஸ் சொல்லிட்டு மார்க்கெட்ல நிறைய இருக்குது. ஏன்னா ரீடிங் வந்து இஸ் அ சேலஞ்ச் வித் திஸ் கண்டிஷன். ஐ எம் டீச்சிங், ஸோ இப்ப வந்து 24/7 ஆன்லைன்ல தான் இருக்கும். அப்புறம் பிள்ளைங்களோட ஒர்க் மார்க் பண்ணும்போது, யூனோ, வி ஹாவ் டு டவுன்லோட் இட் அண்ட் தென் ப்ளூ இட் அப் அண்ட் தென் யூ டூ யோர் நோட்ஸ் அண்ட் தென் யூ சென்ட் இட் பேக் டு தெம் அண்ட் ஆல் தட். மேக்னிஃபைங் கிளாஸ் வந்து இருக்கிறது வந்து கண்டினியூஸா பயன்படுத்த முடியுமா? ஏன்னா மேக்னிஃபைங் கிளாஸ் வந்து நம்ம ரொம்ப பாய்க்க கூடாதுன்னு சொல்லுவாங்க. இப்போ ஒரு பிரிண்ட் வந்து ஸ்மாலா இருக்கிறதுனால ஐ கிளாஸஸ் வந்து லென்ஸ் மாத்தாம அந்த மேக்னிஃபைங் பீஸ வந்து அந்த பேஜுக்கு மேல வச்சா நம்ம வந்து கொஞ்ச நேரம் வாசிக்கலாம். இப்ப இது வந்து புலாங்கா பவிச்சா வேற எதுவும் பாதிப்பு ஏற்படுமா அப்படிங்கறதுதான் என்னுடைய கேள்வி. ரொம்ப பாப்புலர் ஆயிடுச்சு இப்போ.
மேக்னிஃபைங் கிளாஸஸ் ஆக்சுவலி வந்து ஒரு அது ஒரு லோ விஷுவல் எய்ட்னு சொல்லுவோம் நாங்க. லோ விஷன் எய்ட்னு சொல்ற கேட்டகரியில தான் அந்த மேக்னிஃபைங் லென்சஸ் வரும். ஓகே, சோ பேசிக்கலி வை டு யூ நீட் அ லோ விஷன் எய்ட்? இஸ் யுவர் பவர் தட் ஹை? ரொம்ப ஹை பவரா உங்களுக்கு? ரொம்ப ஹை எவ்வளோ உங்க ஷார்ட் சைட் பவர் வந்து கிட்டத்தட்ட எவ்வளோ இருக்கும்? -5 மேல இருக்கா, -7 மேல இருக்கா தெரியுமா? நீங்க மியூட்டா இருக்கீங்க. Can you unmute yourself please?
You can unmute now.
வல்சல மேம், can you unmute yourself? வல்சல மேடம்,
you can unmute now.
Okay, thank you. சரி, எக்ஸாக்ட்டா இப்ப பவர் எவ்வளவுன்னு எனக்கு சரியா தெரியல. ஆனா
roughly
ஒரு I'm not sure.
Okay. So, because the reason I was asking was, if you have only like -2, -3 and all, you will not need a magnifying glasses at all. But vandu ungalku high power irundha, naturally your glasses will not be sufficient. So appadhaan ungalku vandu magnifying glasses thevaipadum. But magnifying glasses use pandradhula onnum thappu kedaiyadhu. It will not harm your eye, or it will not harm your vision. It will not have any long term harmful effects, for sure. That is for sure. So you can use them, but I think magnifying glasses need to be used for text prints,
physical
matlabadi nammaloada in the computer screen la you can just increase the font size. Yeah. The best thing to do. Yeah. Yeah. Otherwise, there's no harm in using magnifying glasses for long. But magnifying glasses, vandu neenga endha type use pandringa? I hope you're not using the round ones.
No, not that one.
The flat ones, right? Okay. And the scale type irukkiradhu, adha thane use pandren. That is fine. Because that helps in giving you clear vision for a longer distance. The round one, enna pannuna, the edges, you know, the letters will be... you should not do that. Scale ones and the prism ones are all fine. Yeah,
இது reading ன்னு சொல்லி நீங்க text மேல வெச்சீங்கன்னா அது வந்து enlarge பண்ணி கொடுக்கும். சோ கொஞ்சம் ஈஸியா இப்ப ஃபைன் கிளாஸ் books எல்லாமே வந்து prints வந்து இப்போதைக்கு என்னால கம்ஃபர்டபிளா படிக்க முடியாது. ஃப்ளோ வந்து அப்படி சரியா வர மாட்டேங்குது. அதனால அது இருந்துச்சுன்னா கொஞ்சம் ஹெல்ப்ஃபுல்லா இருக்கு. ஆனா அது
definitely you can use it. One more thing I can give you a tip is to increase the room light. Room brightness நீங்க இன்க்ரீஸ் பண்ணாலும் அதே மாதிரி if you can have a table lamp over your reading material, that helps a lot in getting a clearer vision. So okay. There are specific table lights, table lamps இருக்கு. Yellow lightல உங்களுக்கு வந்து yellow or white light, நல்ல bright light நீங்க அந்த இதுக்கு மேல வெச்சீங்கன்னா அந்த reading materialக்கு மேல இப்ப clip on மாதிரி நமக்கு table lamps எல்லாம் கிடைக்கும்
இருக்கு.
அந்த மாதிரி light நீங்க வெச்சிட்டு if you keep the magnifying a scale or whatever magnifying gadget you have, if you can keep that, it is absolutely, it will help you a lot. It will relieve the strain, actually. It will actually help you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Next. Hi, ma'am. I am Lata. Good evening.
Good evening.
First of all, it's a very good presentation.
Thank you very much.
Way of your presenting the content is very clear and is very useful to us, ma'am.
Thank you.
And I loved your voice also, ma'am.
Thank you.
Okay, ma'am, I have one doubt, ma'am.
Yeah.
Actually, my husband works as a marine designing engineer, ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
Now he is 36. Yes, 2 years back, he could not see anything for 2 to 3 minutes when he was working, ma'am.
Okay.
And after that, he gets back normal. Mm-hmm. Then doctor was suggested him to wear the glass. Mm-hmm. But he didn't wear it because he worries if he wears glass, it will become a habit to him. But still, I have a fear in that. What can we do for mom?
Okay. So, I have some clarifications from you. I need to get some clarifications. At what age did he get that vision disturbance?
The age of 34, ma'am.
34. And that was a transient episode lasting only for a few minutes.
Yeah, ma'am. 2-3 minutes.
Okay. And then after 2-3 minutes, he immediately got over it. And then after that, he has never got that again.
After that, he didn't get any problem in that, ma'am.
Okay. Does he have any illnesses like diabetes, hypertension, cholesterol, any issues?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. Did he get a headache along with that? So that most probably, see, this transient loss of vision or transient decreased vision is mostly because of many, many reasons, but one of them is migraine. So probably what he got was a migraine attack at that time. But there are many other reasons which you want to rule out, like, you know, if a person is having blood pressure, blood sugar, high blood sugar, high cholesterol, things like that, there may be some abnormality or some blockage of some blood vessels in the brain that will sometimes cause these symptoms. So that is what you have to rule out. But then since it happened only once and then after that no issues, I don't think that should be an issue. Regarding glasses, it's always a myth that, you know, if you start using glasses, then you have to use always. Otherwise, I don't think that's true. If you need glasses, if you cannot see clearly without glasses, then you have to wear glasses. But if you can see without glasses, if you can see clearly without having an eye strain, then very well and fine, you don't need glasses. So it's not like you start using glasses and then you have to you'll be continuously dependent on glasses. That is not a right thing. But if you're worried about him, please take him for another checkup, and then, you know, until and unless we have a checkup in the clinic, we will not be able to correctly identify what the issue is, right, and then treat accordingly.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you very much. Prakash sir.
Yeah. Before your valedictory address, I will take 2 minutes.
Please.
Mr. Stephen. Anyway, you have asked me. Anyway, now, Mr. Dr. Anita has given us a lot of exposure, right from our sitting posture, brightness in the room, eye level, and not using many gadgets. As Rafe was telling, I think I'm pronouncing correctly. This is a real eye opener. But other madam was telling one more eye opener. Do not depend on gadgets. That is easier said than done.
Very true.
It is easier said than done. At this age,
practically almost not possible in this era.
But it's another eye opener. At least that madam made us to be aware and to curtail the usage of digital instrument, items. See, right now, unfortunately, because of the pandemic period, right from LKG boys to senior citizens, we do watch television, we do use mobiles, we do use tablet. It's a good thing. It is a good program covered by Dr. Anita Prabhakar.
Actually, this, as ma'am had mentioned, Mohana ma'am, I think, as she had mentioned, it is true that we cannot completely avoid the use of gadgets, but at least we should be aware that we should minimize the use. That is the point. Take away
the real
messages. At least you should minimize the number of hours spent on a gadget.
Mr. Stephen Sigamani, I don't know, nobody can even guess from where on this earth he is getting presenters, experts, celebrities to conduct the sessions. It gives his programs every week. It happens very frequently, maybe 4 or 5 programs. It is very difficult to catch up everyone, every program. And the programs impart us knowledge enormously. It is, I'm not exaggerating, because it gives a lot of exposure right from Tamil, Telugu, German. Yesterday I was talking to a German. Sir, you have to conduct a program in Germany or about German country, blah, blah, blah. Really, the thing is, Mr. Siepen's service is really very fine. And coming back to again, Dr. Anita, I don't want to talk more, because if I talk more, no, there is one saying, don't blow your trumpet, your own trumpet, like that. And after all, she's my close relative. Anyway, thanks to Mr. Sampath for this arrangement of this program. In fact, instead of my taking a session, I wanted to do something in return for the Sampath service. To be very frank, because over the period I have been watching his program, instead of my taking a program, it is easier to point out somebody. And I suggested my Dr. Anita, my niece, of course. She immediately obliged, in spite of her busy schedules. And again, thanks, Mr. Dr. Anita and Mr. Sampath. Really great.
I should also be thanking my uncle, Mr. B. Prakash, because he let me know, for having told me about such a nice platform where exchange of ideas and lot of people are getting a lot of information. And he was highly appreciating your efforts, Mr. Stephen. And I would also very much applaud all your sincere and great efforts in making the public, making the people, you know, it's not only an entertainment, but also you are also helping in a way of creating more awareness of important topics for the public. That is also really appreciable. And that's when he told me about the various sessions what you were conducting. So when he asked me, I said I would be more than happy to do that for him. Yeah. So thank you to my uncle, and thank you
first,
to
you. First, I should thank Mr. Prakash sir, because it is not like I'm doing all things. I'm just initiating. Like Prabhakar sir, there are a lot of people giving contacts. Through contacts, people are accepting to talk. So I should appreciate, I should extend my gratitude to the people who are coming here and delivering their lecture and sharing their experiences. So this goes on like this. So I should appreciate, it is a teamwork. It is a teamwork. Really, I'm happy, really. There are a lot of people who doesn't ask, do you have time?
Yeah.
Do you have time? Okay, is there anybody wants to talk further? Any questions from other people?
Chat box, I don't know. Are there any questions in the chat box?
No questions from the chat box. Only the appreciation they sent. Any questions from the other people? Where are you? Are you talking to me? Anybody? Could you please ask your father to say a few words?
My father?
Hmm.
Yeah. Achha, please unmute yourself. Achha, mute ana. Unmute chiyu. Yeah.
Just like others, I only have to say that I also learned a lot.
Thank you, sir. It's really a great pleasure here. People like you are coming and joining us. So we are really proud to say that such a people are coming, and I can say to many people about you. Thank you. Thank you. Thanks for joining us, really. Okay, anybody wants to talk? Are you people are taking 20 minutes, 20, 20, 20 now? Okay, right. So I think all are in 20, 20.
One of my friend, Dr. Bissi, is also here. I can see here. Please, she's please, from Kuwait. She's an ENT doctor.
Let her talk.
Yeah, I.
Dr. Bissi, please.
Bissi, hi. I'm so happy. Bissi, can you unmute yourself, please? Can you unmute yourself, Bissi, please? Yeah. Hi, Bissi.
Hi, I'm at work.
Oh, so you're at work. Okay. Yeah. Are you on duty today? Okay.
Yes, I'm on duty. But okay. It was so, I joined towards the question and answer session. I missed the first part.
Yeah.
As always, I was so happy to see you.
Thank you very much. I'm so happy to see your name as well. So that's why I called you.
Yeah.
Really happy to see you.
Yeah.
We were colleagues for, she's an ENT specialist and I'm an ophthalmologist, but we used to work together and we are very good friends. So I just sent the link to her today.
So,
in spite of her duty, she has joined. I'm really, really thankful to her.
I think we should engage Dr. Bissi also.
Yeah, that's a nice thing.
Stephen, sir.
Yeah.
நம்ம பிரகாஷ் சார்ட்டையும் ஒரு நாளைக்கு ஏதாவது ப்ரோக்ராம் பண்ண சொல்லுங்க செஷன்.
அவரை 10 நாள் பண்ண சொல்லுங்க, கவலைப்படாதீங்க. So I couldn't get any answer from with Dr. Busy. So am I disturbing?
I think she might be busy. Yeah.
I think. It's just a request. If you feel okay, then you can join anytime when you're free.
Okay, I'll let you all know.
Please think and yeah. let us know. You just talk to Anita, Dr. Anita, then we will it is not a hurry. Yeah, I'm just giving a request. So whenever it is possible, you please join us and give your share your knowledge. We'll let us know, learn something from you also.
I will let you know. Thank you so much.
I don't think why I joined yet.
Thank you very much, Bissi, for joining. Thank you. Have a good day. Thank you.
Really thank you. Any other anyone wants to talk? Okay, it's time, I think.
My another uncle is there. I just want to hear from him.
Please.
please unmute yourself. Yeah.
Good evening, Anita.
Hi, good evening.
Very good speech. I know that you, whenever you handle any topic, it would be very perfect and very useful and informative. So that's why I just didn't say anything so far. But you have covered everything very, very simple and understandable way. And you make an awareness, awakening and awareness on the eye. So to say, it is an eye-opener. That's a normal word they use. You are really open to the eyes of many people.
Thank you.
Okay, very nice. Thank you.
Thank you, Dimame. One more person from Australia. Yes. I hope he's there. Mr. Padma Kumar. He's also my relative.
Please.
Yeah. Yeah, hi. Hello. He's speaking from Australia.
കണ്ടു അന്നേരം തൊട്ട് കണ്ടുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുകയാണ്. Dr. Anita.
Okay. I took your number. I'll share you, sir.
Yeah. Give me your link so I can send it to someone more of my family members. Okay. Thank you.
I upload it, then I'll share it to you. Then you can share it.
Yeah.
To people.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for joining. Thanks for your time.
Thank you very much for joining.
Yeah. Yeah. Anybody who wants to say a few words? I think it's a time to conclude. Ajay, do you want to talk something? Krishnika, pesnuma edach pesringa Krishnika? Krishnika solunga pesunga.
Romba nalla irundichu. Naan nadiye kattukada ana naanga vandha screen paakumbodhu ana vision kuraiyuma?
ஸ்கிரீன் பார்க்கும்போது விஷன் குறையுமான்னு கேட்டால் ஒரு விதத்தில் குறையலாம். ஏன்னா நான் சொன்ன மாதிரி குவாரண்டைன் மயோப்பியான்னு ஒரு என்டிட்டியே புதுசாக வந்திருக்கு இப்போ. ஏன்னா வந்து நம்ம ரொம்ப நேரம் ஸ்க்ரீன் பார்க்கறதுனால நம்மளோட கண்ணுக்குள்ள ஒரு மசில் ரொம்ப ஸ்ட்ரெயின் ஆகி கண்ணோட லென்த்தே வித்தியாசம் வந்து அதனால நமக்கு கிளாஸஸ் விஷன் குறைஞ்சு கிளாஸஸ் யூஸ் பண்ண வேண்டிய நிலைமைக்கு வந்திருக்கு. ஸோ அந்த அந்த ஒரு பாசிபிலிட்டி இருக்கு. அது மட்டும் இல்லாமல் இப்போ நான் சொன்ன மாதிரி ட்ரைனஸ் வந்தாலே நமக்கு விஷன் கம்மியாக இருக்கலாம். ஸோ அது வந்து ஆனால் டிரான்சியண்டாக தான், கொஞ்சம் டெம்பரரியாக தான் இருக்கும். கொஞ்ச நேரத்துக்கு தான் அது, நம்ம ஏதாவது ட்ரீட்மெண்ட் எடுத்தா இல்லை நம்ம ஈவன் பிளிங்க் பண்ணா கூட அது கிளியர்
Thank you, Krishnika.
Thank you.
Yeah, all the best. Bye. Okay, thank you very much. Really, it's a wonderful time. After hearing your voice and your presentation and your tips, there are many things, not only for the eyes, and it is, you covered totally 360 degree health issues. But the thing is, what we should realize, instead of taking a break from the digital, we should first realize how much time we are spending on the screen time. And we should calculate which are the useful time.
Yeah, there are actually, on telephones, there are
apps which say, not apps, they have incorporated that you have reached your screen limit or you have reached your time limit, like that. It records how much time you spend on the screen. It gives a average screen time. So that helps sometimes.
Yeah, that helps them. As a psychologist, I'm a psychologist. Mm-hmm. What I'm saying now, see, we should realize, once realized our what we are doing, so then automatically we take action. Once we are, so that is needed actually. So that is an added tips I'm giving. We should realize what we are doing and how much time we are spending on the mobile, how much time we are spending on the laptop, and what are the time productive and what are the time wasted and what are the time entertaining. When we see, when we find out all these things, once we self-aware everything, then it is easy for us to break and follow 2020. Really, the tips is 2020 is wonderful. We share to everyone. So thanks for your time. Really wonderful, wonderful, wonderful talk. And there are a lot of messages. Patiently, you answer for all the people. We really thank on behalf of our whole team. I'm thanking you and your Mr. Prakash Sir and your people who joined from the Kerala and Australia and the other country. So it is our pleasure to extend our real gratitude with feel and love. Okay, thank you very much. Thanks for the opportunity, Prabhakar sir. Really, I wonderful appreciate you, and you took an initiative to give this wonderful opportunity. So really, we enjoyed, we learned a lot. Thank you very much. Thank you, Dr. Anita. Thank you for everyone. Thank you, Prabhakar and Sarappa. Thank you very much. Thank you, Achila, madam.
Thank you. Bye. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you, Batma, madam. Bye. Prema, madam. Vasantam. Vasanthi, madam, thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr.
Vasanthi, madam. அது நம்ம டீம்ல சொல்லி சொல்லி படக்க ஆயிடுச்சு.
Thank you, Dr. Anita. Very useful.
Thank you.
You're most welcome. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Permal sir. Are you there? Okay, he's not there actually. He's my friend. He joined the list. Thank you, Ravi sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Anita madam. I'll talk to you over phone.
Thank you.
Whenever you find me. Bye.